Hello. Yeah, so last time I vlogged or something, I don't know what it was, but basically we're in Pahia, and we're in this nice little place, and these people basically offered to let us stay here, free accommodation, if we work, like, for 1 to 2 hours a day in the garden. So that's what we're doing. That's me. And now we're going to go fishing and hopefully not get bit, like, eaten by a shark.
Hello, it's the 27th of January. And it's been a while since I've done a video, but just wanted to give you a little video just because, like, of this out here. I mean, look at this.
Whoa.
New Zealand, what are you up to?
Look at that.
What is happening out there? So, yeah, it's very loud in here, but if I have a chance to do like a proper vlog, I'll do it tomorrow. But Joe keeps using up all the chocolate spread. To be honest, it's quite nice. Alright, so yeah, we didn't get a chance to actually work outside because it pretty much started when I was ready to go. And yesterday was the first day with the drone, but I'll explain that tomorrow when you can hear me.
Hello and welcome back to New Zealand 5. I can't believe it, we're on the fifth episode already. And yeah, I really hope you're enjoying the series so far. This one is quite another big segment, to be honest. This is like a 2 week period that I'm going to try and whittle down all into this one episode. So it could be quite intense. So if I speak fast, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to keep it within, you know, hopefully 50 minutes or below or whatever. So without further ado, let's get into New Zealand number 5. Right, so picking up from the last episode, we got dropped off by the millionaire in Pahia. So we were walking around trying to find a hostel or something, a cheap one or a campground, and we remembered the one that we stayed at when we caught the bus from there up to the start of the walk, okay? And we thought, oh, you know, we might as well go check there. So we're walking there, and we're walking past some housing estates and all this, and basically this woman starts shouting out to us, going like, guys, and we're like, is she talking to us? And it's like, so we went over and she said, guys, are you woofers? And we just kind of went, yes. We were just like, we were unsure of what it meant, but we were kind of like, think that's working for accommodation? So we just kind of went, yeah. She's like, right, well, you know, you can stay in this big shed thing pretty much, and for free, and all you have to do is tend the garden for like an hour and a half to 2 hours a day. We were like, all right, that sounds good. We looked in the shed, it's got a fridge, it had a sink, toilet, shower, bed, and yeah, they had free Wi-Fi, and we're just like, yeah, let's do this. This is amazing. And pretty much, we ended up staying there for 2 whole weeks, which is crazy. Now, the reason I'm doing 2 weeks in one bit is because this whole section happened as one. As in, there wasn't a lot to do, to be honest. So there's not that much to tell, but there's some stuff that happened. Like, for instance, to start with, we did a lot of fishing. Hopefully there's some pictures coming up on screen of me out here, you know, fishing and all this and blah, blah, blah. We fished like nearly every day. It was incredible because they gave us a fishing rod and some stuff, and we did lose a lot of, you know, weights and all that. But as you can see, I did catch a couple of little whippersnappers, which I'm, yeah, very happy about. And Joe did catch some stuff as well. And yeah, that was just like so fun actually, just basically fishing without bait as well, which was a new thing for me. I think I made my brother proud. I think I made you proud, James. Those absolute whoppers I caught. But yeah, we also went out in their dinghy that they had. And that's like just crazy in itself because like, I was sat at the front of the dinghy. You had to hold onto this skinny little rope whilst Joe was controlling the motor. You always had to go head on to the waves, and the waves out there are insane. And so we were just going like that. It was crazy. We had this little mobile phone with us. I mean, the guy, Chris and Carla were the people that we stayed with. The guy said, oh, have you guys got a Johnny? Is that, sorry? So have you got a condom? So I was like, well, yeah. Packing heat. So I took it, but he didn't tell us what to do with it. I was like, what the hell does he want us to do with that? But I forgot it was in my pocket. When we got into the ocean to start up the dinghy, it kind of floated out of my pocket, and he kind of went, have you got Johnny? It's to put the phone in. to waterproof it. And it's like, that's what it for. Check my pockets. I was like, where is it? See it floating in the water towards children. This king-sized Johnny. Oh. I don't think they noticed. But anyway, yes. So we had a lot of fun there. They were quite strange. Like Chris, he would talk for ages. Carla, she was very loud. But they were very nice people. And my camera's going to run out of battery. That's just fantastic. Yes, as you can see in the clip here, we did some kayaking.
Whoa. Oh, Joe, I'm going the wrong way already. There he is. There's Joe. Look how fast I'm going. I should be in Olympics or something. We're going to that island there. So here we go. I'm like, this is so easy. Joe, I'm filming.
It was torrential rain at some point. It was crazy. But because of the free Wi-Fi, we decided we can actually sit there and like watch some films, you know, kind of chill out a little bit because we were kind of saving money from working and not paying for the accommodation. So sat back watching some film stuff, and this is where Joe shot some of these little funny videos, which I didn't know he was filming, so here you go.
Mate, speed of a booblet.
You see the thing about Dover?
Yeah, it's that rising there, isn't
it? Yeah. As soon as we leave. Oh, here we go, fin off one, we don't care. So what if you have 50 parties a week, whatever?
I got some snacks here, mate. You're gay!
But yeah, there was a couple of times where we were, we could drink and stuff because we were saving some money. And, you know, we bought some vodka and stuff and we actually went out on the town. Now the thing is, the guy, Chris, and Carla, actually, they both drove us there. But as they're driving us there, down into the town, they said, oh yeah, just a quick few rules, you know, don't really go up to any Maoris or anything, because they're going to be quite aggressive once they've had a few drinks. Yeah, don't go near the Maori women as well, because they're looking for somewhere to stay and all this. We're like, what the hell? He's like, yeah, well, I'll introduce you to all the bouncers so you stay safe, and yeah, have a good night. It's like, what? It's like, where are we going? Like, some motorbiker flipping bar or something. But basically, we got in there as a bunch of just, like, German students and stuff, and it was alright, but we were just like, we had a thing called a PP bomb, which is like a Jaeger bomb, and it was just like, no, apologise, the camera just ran out of battery. Fantastic. But anyway, where was I? Yeah, so we went in down in the town, we actually had an okay night and everything, but anyway, we got up to a sort of a lot of stuff-ish, but within that 2 weeks, compared to the hitchhiking around, it wasn't a lot. So obviously we were just trying to save money, do all that, and we were just having a good time in Paihia. You know, just each day we would get up and go fishing or whatever and stuff like that. So in that kind of sense, it was a bit more of a holiday type thing. You know, it wasn't five star, obviously, but you know, it was all right. But then what happened was Chris, very intelligent man, was trying to build a drone with his buddy. And basically, they were asking us if we wanted to help towards the project to basically set the next world record for the highest, longest hovering drone ever, or something like that. And basically, like, for the first day or whatever, we did some welding and stuff like that, like, soldering, sorry. And yeah, it just, like, we got hyped up and all this, and I think I put a picture on Facebook to my family, like, oh, we're working on a secret drone or something. Yeah, I don't know. But then after that, it kind of fizzed away, and then we just kind of got sick of staying there, because we were bored, you know, just doing the same things and everything, and eventually, we wanted to move on, and we wanted to go down to Whangarei, I would call it, but it's like Whangarei, as they call it. But yes, Chris did give us a lift down there, and that was the one and only... the one and only ride we actually got charged for. Bearing in mind, this guy was very wealthy as well. Yeah, he charged us $5 pretty much each. I couldn't believe it. So I don't even count that. I don't count it. Because, like, you think about how much we save. But anyway, he always did this thing. He would sit on the phone and he had, like, a gammy elbow. So he'd always, like, have his elbow like this when he's on the phone. And he'd be going, yo, Matthew. And he would just, like, walk away. He was like that kind of intelligent person that he would sit there and tell you stuff and tell you stuff. He would just, oh, just throw it all on you. One night, we actually thought he was mental because he had his mate staying, okay? I forgot his name. But his mate was staying there. Whilst we were staying there, this guy was going to stay for a couple of nights. He was going to be using our bathroom. But on our shed door, we just have like a lock on the inside. Just like at night, we just lock it and then we're safe, you know? And bearing in mind, the guy had seen the bathroom earlier, but like Chris hadn't pointed out, you know, fully. About, I think it was nearly midnight, we hear like this knocking at the door, and me and Joe just kind of look at each other and just go, pretend you're asleep, pretend you're asleep. Like, I can't be bothered to go up and open the door and all this. And then he was going, like, knock, 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 you guys awake and all this? Like, just nothing. And then we kind of, it kind of went quiet. We thought, okay, he's gone now. Bang! He flipping breaks into his own shed, bending the door bar, and just goes, trying to bloody torture us pretty much. Like, I thought we were getting swatted. And it was just like, oh, sorry guys, just wanted to show Tony. That was it, Tony the toilet. He goes, right, yeah, it's just through there. And Tony went, yeah, okay, cool. All right, have a good night, guys. Me and Joe just sat there looking at each other, just like, what the hell happened there? He just broke into his own shed to show him the toilet. It was at that moment where we were just like, I want to go. This is weird. The guy's weird. He's bloody breaking into his own shed. He's talking about dolphins for about an hour and a half or something. And there was this one time where this lovely German girl, I think she was German, she came and, you know, worked and stayed there, but she was sleeping in her car and all this. And yeah, tried, failed. Oh well. Yes, I definitely recommend Paihia as one of the best places in, I'd say, the North Island, at least, of New Zealand, from what we saw, I think. It's very good, but only for a short period, because you do run out of stuff to do. And just trying to think, did we actually do anything else whilst we were there? We picked some oysters, but turned out they were contaminated, so we had to throw them back. That was terrible, but yeah. That's pretty much it. Pretty much here's, I think this would be like probably the last clip of just me and Joe enjoying a nice drink.
Ready? We're going to chink the old glasses.
I know that's super cringy, but get over it. But yes, thank you very much for watching. From here, we're pretty much getting to Whangarei, okay? Or Whangarei, which will be the next location, which gets pretty crazy, and there's some really nice footage that's coming, like really nice visually, you know, instead of that crappy stuff in the shed and all that. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed, hope you're loving the New Zealand series. Make sure to drop a like or a dislike if you didn't like it. Leave a comment, and I will see you in the next one. See you later.